Hey guys, welcome back to the Market Build. Last video we got the axle installed, a few of the front end components like steering, pedals, bumper, wheels and spindles, brakes. And in today's video we're going to try to get a lot more stuff done because we ordered a lot of parts. We got seat, wheels, floor pan, engine, fuel tanks, and a bunch of other miscellaneous pieces. Engine, you guys already know, it's an IME 60cc, makes I think about 10 horsepower or something. So yeah, we're going to try to get this stuff installed. We got this OMPC from Murray Motorsports for about like $60 or something. Wheels from Go Power Sports were pretty pricey, but it's a really nice set of wheels. Floor pan came originally from Margate.com. And then fuel tank and other small stuff was from eBay, you know, little private sellers. So yeah, we're going to try to get most of the stuff installed today. Engine, seat, la la la. And we actually got a little sneak peek for you guys. This engine isn't going to be our permanent engine. We got something else that's going to be a lot better. Little hint, it's water cooled and it's worth probably two times or three times as much. So yeah, that's all we're going to give you guys. So stay tuned guys. In the video we're going to be doing a lot of tips and tricks like wheel seat, how to install that stuff, just to make it a little bit simpler for you guys. And yeah, follow us on Broke Boy Builds on Instagram. And we also made a separate account for this cart on Instagram too. We're going to leave all that stuff down in the description below so you guys can go ahead and give us a follow. So yeah, let's get into assembling this thing. Alright guys, so we're going to take out the new wheels right now, but we're gonna put them on this blanket because when you're installing them it's easy to scratch up the rims and you don't really want to do that because they're silver and they're fresh. So you don't want to necessarily ruin them. So just put something soft underneath them. The size that we got, it's a 11.5 by 8 by 6 inch rim. So we thought 9 inches wide is gonna be a little bit too wide. So we went with 8 inches and the rims are 8.5. So it is gonna be a little bit of like a lip offset, but I think that's gonna be just perfect. The rims are aluminum DWT from Go Power Sports. We'll leave links in the description for you guys. So let's go ahead and try to get both of these installed, and yeah. Alright guys, so we got one tire on. It was kind of a struggle because that last little lip was just going on. But basically what we did is we took the nipple out, the like little thing inside the nipple, and then we basically took this, let it build up a ton of pressure, like 100 PSI, and we just went straight in, well bam, went, got it on. We're gonna do the second one. This one's gonna be super fast time lapse because it's kind of boring seeing it twice, so yeah. See you later, alligator. So right now we're gonna go ahead and install the floor pan. So we're gonna go ahead and tape this black one just because it's brand new and we don't wanna scratch it up. We're gonna tape it up and then mark our holes, drill them out, and then bolt it on. We also got a bolt kit that came straight from Margate, so that's gonna be very handy. And we have this gas tank that fits in like absolutely perfect. Kind of a struggle to get it in. I put it in the wrong way.
But that's going to go on right after we bolt on the...
Yeah, after we do the floor pan, we'll get this done. This gas tank, it's a 4-quart gas tank.
Oh, man.
Oh, Alright, we'll figure that out later. It's a 4-quart gas tank, and it's absolutely perfect for the cart. As you can see, it's not too wide, and it just clears the tire rods perfectly. So, yeah, we're going to try to get that installed right after. Thank you. Alrighty guys, so we got the fuel tank on, floor pan on, we reinstalled the steering shaft, everything is nice and tight, sturdy. Now what we want to do, we're kind of going to lay off the seat because we want to get most of the stuff installed so that when you sit down, you're actually as comfortable, because if we're going to be changing steering wheels and stuff, that's going to suck. So right now what we're going to try to do is we're going to change these pedals because they looked cool at first, but at the end of the day, they're not really that nice, and we're going to go with the original Margie ones. Those are a lot better. This isn't going to be as much work. It's like a few bolts and little clips. So yeah, let's swap the pedals, and then I think we're going to go ahead and install the engine. So, yeah. It's like one of the most crucial parts of the go-karts and stuff. Like, it really ties in the whole frame. It actually starts to look like a go-kart after that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take some piece of wood that you have and some clamps, and we want to mark up the lowest part of our frame. So just take a piece of wood, clamp it onto the frame however you can, wherever you can. Want to clamp it up, and then when you put the seat, you see that that's the lowest point. You can still pick it up a little bit if you would like, or whatever your preference is. This seat, it's rounded. It's not the flat ones. Flat ones are a little bit easier to install, but we're just gonna go with this one because it's a little more comfortable. So we're gonna need to mark up all the holes, drill it, and then we're gonna need to find our sliders because Margie did like a little bit of a different design. So we're gonna have to find that, mark everything up, drill it, and install the seat. Alrighty guys, so that's gonna be it for today's video. You saw us get the floor pan installed, drill out all the holes. We got the fuel tank installed, also drilled out all the holes. So it's really nice, sturdy, all the proper hardware. We also got the brand new wheels installed, rims and tires. We showed you how to put the tires onto the rims, which was kind of a long process, but we all got it done. We got the engine installed and we got the seat installed. So for this video, we made a lot of progress. This kart actually looks like a go-kart now. We have a few little things left, like we need to buy tie rods, new steering system, because like this steering was broken. We gotta get some new hubs and stuff. We still gotta complete our whole drivetrain and finish the brakes. Please consider subscribing, putting a like to this video. Stay tuned for next video. It's gonna be a very good video. And yeah, we'll see you guys on the next one.